The following is something I made up, but by reading this, you have made it real. It is best to prepare beforehand, so that way, everything can be on time. Timing is very important in this game. You will need a dark room, with or without windows. Windows if you want safety. If you have windows, there must be curtains or sheets on them. No light can be seen. There may be furniture in the room, but not much. The floor should be clean. I don't recommend having anything hanging on the walls. They may fall down, depending on how the game goes. There should be some sort of seating arrangement for at least 3 people, or no more than 5 people. This includes a circle of chairs or a couch/love seat. I recommend the chairs if you do not wish to share a seat. The room is ready. I recommend memorizing the way to your seat. You will not want to bump into anything on your way there. I also recommend having your game room on the same floor as your bedroom. Go to bed at 8 o'clock that night. You will want sleep. It is imperative that you sleep for a duration of time, no matter how short. Leave your room at 11:50. Put a blindfold on your eyes before you leave. Walk to your seat. Do not be alarmed. Nobody will block you. Sit in your chair. When you feel that 10 minutes have passed, you will know because it will felt like 20 minutes. Invite them in. If it happens that you do not want to go through with the game, then go back to your bed without taking off your blindfold. If you wait longer than 10 minutes, they will be offended and enter anyway. Do not let them enter on their own accord. If you take off your blindfold, it is a signal of fear. They like your fear. You do not want them to like your fear. If it happens that you want to play, say calmly, but firmly, "Come in and be obedient." They will come in. They are your guests. They are yours to entertain. So be polite. Be mindful of your manners and do not remove your blindfold. You do not want to see them. Be very specific of what you want them to do. They will do exactly what you do, and do not tell them to. Before anything else, tell them your rules. You are their host, and they will not disobey you. Be specific. Tell them how you expect them to act. Tell them if they are or are not allowed to touch you. Tell them what they can or cannot touch in the room. Tell them where they can go. They are like children. Instruct them with precision. You may tell them to sit. They will sit. You will know when they are seated. You may ask them questions. They may lie to you. You will not know when they are lying. You may ask them to knock on the walls. They will knock. You will hear them knocking, as will anyone else in the house. The other person may wake up from the knocking. If she or he does, pray that whatever pain comes to you will be swift. You may ask them about your future. They will not know. They will not tell you. You may do anything, but you must not cross their lines. You will know when you are crossing their lines. If you wish to ask them something, and you feel even the slightest hint of something wrong, do not ask it, and do not mention it. The moment you cross their lines, you are dead. Remember to never take off your blindfold. They will ask you to. They will beg you to. They will try to force you with the sweetest tongues and the harshest tones. No matter what, do not take off your blindfold. And above all, do not be harsh with them. You are their host. They are your guests. You must never be unkindly to them. They will see it as a threat and take care of you as seen fit. When you are done with them, tell them to leave and not return unless you invite them to do so. Tell them that you enjoyed their time. They love your flattery. You will know when they are gone. Do not take off your blindfold. When they are gone, walk back to your room and go to bed. Do not take off your blindfold. Sleep. You will dream of nothing bad. You may take off your blindfold when you wake, so long as it is daylight. For the rest of your life, they will follow you, but they will never be in plain sight, and they will never be there when you look at them. They will always want another chance to meet you. Do not exceed 3 meetings. After the 3rd meeting, they may invite you. You cannot decline their invitation.